An exclusive investigation into health and safety at Talley's, one of the country's biggest food producers. A whistleblower tells One News the company's frozen food factory in Ashburton, where a woman recently had her hand crushed, is another accident waiting to happen. Reporter Thomas Mead visited the plant today to ask the hard questions.
To the public, Talley's presents a spotless image, staff producing frozen veggies with a smile on their face. But tonight, One News can pull back the curtain. These leaked photos, taken by an anonymous whistleblower, show a different side to the Ashburton factory.
I'm sorry, but these guys, they are lying to them. They are lying to their customers.
We've chosen to replace his voice for his protection. Talley's is one of our biggest food companies. Their produce in supermarkets all over the country. But they've seen several accidents. Across their many operations, one worker has been decapitated at sea, another paralysed, and others injured in preventable incidents, prompting one worker here in Ashburton to come forward.
To me, what they are doing, they don't even care because these people are easily replaceable.
Sharing these images of filthy machines, one coated in burnt grease, the other with corn juice. In another, a contractor stands on top of a loaded truck, and here a machine has exposed pinch points where people can be trapped.
If your hand is trapped in the machine, your fingers or whatever, the machine keeps running.
In response today, Talley's claimed the photos were taken out of context and sent us these, saying they do address issues whenever they arise.
It is cleaned regularly. You're always going to get some heat stain on there. You're always going to get some build-up on there.
What I'm showing you has not been there for 1 or 2 days. It's been there for months.
The company saying hazards like those pinch points have since been put under a guard as part of their regular audits.
So you would contend that everyone working here is safe?
I contend that we have a safe site, yes.
Except just 3 months ago, a woman had her hand stuck in a machine on the Ashburton corn line. A leaked email showing Talley's had to call emergency services to get her out and then told staff to keep quiet. Writing, do not share any information, discuss or pass comment about this incident outside the business.
Was she safe?
If she had followed the proper procedures, she would be.
WorkSafe investigated but didn't take any further action. The two sides could not be more opposed. Talley's refuting any suggestion they put profit over their staff.
Everyone can see it. Everyone, managers, supervisors, everyone is there. They know it's there. They just walk away.
I feel that we are definitely doing everything we can to try and make sure that people do go home safely on a daily basis.
So while the company may feel it's safe, it seems not everyone agrees.
All right, for more, let's go live to Thomas now. Tell us about your visit to the factory, Thomas. How did it go?
Well, we had hoped to go inside that factory. Talley's initially invited us, said come on in and see things for yourself, but they changed their mind at the last minute, citing commercial sensitivity. It followed an extraordinary meeting in their boardroom where their chief executive, the head of health and safety, a communications professional, and two other members of local site management spoke to us for around 45 minutes, essentially trying to stop us from running this article tonight. They threatened us with legal action, saying that those photographs were taken again out of context and, quote, not an issue of public importance or safety. That was followed soon afterward by an email from their lawyer where they threatened to injunct TVNZ, an action which would have seen this head to the High Court. But ultimately, they chose not to do that. We were able to air this story tonight. It's fair to say that the chief executive did not want these pictures to be aired. He told me that directly in our meeting. But it is also fair to say that they are in the public interest, given that these products are in many freezers all over New Zealand. And while it's important to say that there's no indication at this stage that there's any food hygiene risk, we simply don't know that, it's important for people to be able to look at the story, see both sides, and make their own mind up.
Kia ora, Thomas. In Ōtautahi, Christchurch, Thomas Mead.